Okay, so what were we doing last time? I think we were dealing with a list. Okay, so we were looping over the list. Okay, now let's move ahead. So yesterday what we did, we studied about the list. What are the data structures? What are the different type of data structures in the Python that is user defined in the built-in? And we were concerned about the built-in data structures of the Python, and we started with the list. And as told you, list is very important, even the most important data structure of entire data structures which are available inside the Python. Okay, so we were able to loop through the list. Now suppose what happens, requirement is what? My requirement is I need index of each element of the list. Okay, understand the requirement. My requirement is I need index of each element of the list. Okay, so let me take the same list, doesn't matter. Let me take the same list, or I can create a new list. It's up to me entirely. Suppose let me take this list, this one, and we run this cell. Let me create a new cell here. Let me take this list. Okay, what I need to know, I need access of index of each element of these. Means I need that index of 3 is 0. I know virtually that index of 3 is 0, index of 4 is 1, index of 5 is 1, sorry, 5 is 2, and index of 6 is 3. But I need it somewhere. I may need it to store somewhere as well. I don't know. You never know the requirement, right? So suppose I know the index of each element of these. So how can I do that? For that, we have a function known as enumerate. Remember, we have a function known as enumerates. How it will work, understand properly. What I'm doing, I'm typing for, let's say I mention number in. Normally, how do we write? After in, we write our iterable like numbers. That way, what happens is this number in every iteration is equal to the element of these numbers, right or wrong? If we write this way for number in numbers, then in every iteration, this loop variable will be having the value of elements of list. It means in first iteration, the number will be 3. In next iteration, number will be 4. In next iteration, number will be 5. In next iteration, number will be 6. Right or wrong? Please tell me, is it okay with everyone till this point?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now,
Yes, sir.
suppose what I want to access means I'm able to access the value of element that 3, 4, 5, 6, which is available in the number. But right now, what I want the index as well. How can I do that? So what I have to do before this numbers means I have to use a function known as enumerate, E-N-U, enumerate function, right? And close this iterable inside this. Now, what will happen? Once I put this enumerate, this number will no longer remain individual variable. It will become a tuple. The moment I put enumerate here, this number will become a tuple. Tuple knows, everyone knows the tuple. This way means this kind of element. Like, and it will be storing two elements. It will be storing two elements. First, it will be storing the index. Okay. And second, it will be storing the value. So what will happen now? Earlier, what was happening? This was simple as scalar value. It was storing the whatever value you were giving here. For example, you were putting here some example 3. So number would have been 3. Would I put up my name Praveer? The number would have been Praveer, means single value. Value it was storing. So what will happen once I put an enumerate function here, right? This number will become a tuple now, and it will store two values. One, the index of the value. Index of the value. So everybody can tell me, in first iteration, what will be the value of number? In first iteration, what will be the value of number? Please
Zero
tell me.
comma three.
Yes, absolutely right. 0,3. In next iteration?
Four
Next
comma one.
iteration? No, opposite you are telling.
One
1
comma
comma 4.
one.
4.
1 comma 4, right? In next iteration?
2,5.
Perfect, perfect. 100% perfect, right? I don't think so. There should be any issue in that. So what we can do now, we know it's tuple. So how to access the elements of the tuple? Simple. Tuples are accessed the same way we access the list, right? So what we can do here, suppose whatever you said, I want to print that. What I can type, print in bracket. Okay, number is a tuple, so I type number. And remember, how do we access? Suppose I put zero in the bracket. So it will return me the index value. Similarly, if I type number one, so this number one will return the value. Okay, so this number is zero, this index zero is there. So number is a tuple, we know. And at the zeroth index, what is stored? Index of the value. So index will be returned. And here, number one, number one is at one position, what is there? Value. So value will be written. So what I will get, same what you said. In first iteration, what will be printed? 0, 3, 0, 3. In next iteration, 1, 4. In next iteration, 0, 5. Next iteration, I'm repeating once again. From first iteration, it will be 0, 3. Next iteration, it will be 1, 4. Next iteration, it will be 2, 5. And in the last iteration, it will be 3, 6. So let me run that and let's check the output. Can you see, please? 0, 3, 1, 4, 2, 5, 3, 6. Any doubt in this? Please tell me.
No, sir.
Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Please, everyone, please pay attention and tell me.
Yes,
sir. Okay. Now, there is one more method of doing that. The way list can be unpacked. Remember what was unpacking? Anybody remember what was unpacking? Suppose there was a list known as L and it has two values, 1, 2. So how could we unpack that list? I suppose I run this and I go back down. So I could unpack like this. It is having two values. So I could have put two variables here, x, y equals to L. Right? This was your unpacking. So x would have become 1 and 2 would have become y. So your tuple can also be unpacked. Tuple can also be unpacked. So what I can do now, I'm taking same program again. See. Now I am typing, I know number is a tuple. Number is a tuple for sure. So let me unpack that. I know number will be having two values. So if I put, instead of one value, if I put two values, like I can put first value I know is index, comma, second value I know is value. Sorry, I'm typing at the wrong place. Second value is value. So what will happen? Instead of numbers, first will become index, second will become value. It's very much like this. Very much like this means I'm writing this. Index, comma, value equal to number. It's very much like this. Is it okay? It's like this. So instead of using number, I use their unpacked value. So same value I put it here. Okay, so if I want to access index and value, no problem. Instead of writing this way, I can write instead of number, I can put index here. And number one position, I can put value here. And same things will be repeated. Please check it. Both are exactly identical. Is it okay, everyone? Please pay proper attention and tell me if having any doubt, even 1%, please tell me right now. What's the purpose of enumerate? And how can we access the element of the tuple? And how I have converted this number thing, into this index and value thing? Tell me. Can I put X and Y here? Please tell me. Instead of index, can I put X? And can I put Y here or not? Instead of index and value, can I put X, Y?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I can put anything I want. Remember, it's a loop variable and variables can be named as per our requirement. But I should understand that at X position, if I'm putting index to be X, value to be Y, so I should remember that X will be index for sure. Y will be value for sure. See properly, take your time. I'm giving you 1 minute to think of any doubt you're having, please tell me. And remember, what's the usage of enumerate? It's very important.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, please tell me.
Sir, can we append this into a list?
I'll do that. Don't worry. Anything you can do. Anything you can do. It's entirely up to you. I'm coming to that purpose only. Means we will adding or removing item from the list only. Anything you can do. Don't worry. We are having a value now. So whatever you want to do, we can do that. Let me show you if you want to see. Example, at every iteration, I want to append index and values. Let me take an empty list. Okay. Let me take my empty list. And let's say the name is indexes. Okay. This is an empty list. And what I want to do, every index I want to append here. So I will do that indexes. Okay, this is an empty list dot append. Okay. And what you want to append, suppose you want to append index only, just index. So in every iteration, your new index value will be appended to this. If you want to see, you will get this index to be having value 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Let me run that and you can check it out. Don't worry. Let me run this. Okay. And let me check the indexes list. Please check. Is it fine?
Yeah.
Okay. Once it is in list, I tell you, once it is in inside the list or any value there, it's everything is in your control now. You can modify it the way you want. List give you immense power. Is it fine, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I'm moving ahead. If you didn't get an idea about the append, don't worry. I'm moving to that only. Okay. So this thing is clear to everyone. I hope so. So next thing we are going to move is adding and removing items from the list. Adding and removing items from the list. Okay. This is our next step. We want to remove and add the items from the list. Okay. So how can we do that? There are different ways. So let me create a list. Let's say list is letters. And I inside this, I put an element A. Then I put an element B, and then I put an element C. Okay. This is a list. Name is letters. Now, list data structure, okay, has different methods you can work on. Has different methods you can work on. How to know that? The way to is that once you execute your list, that it, list is having the name letters and it is having the value A, B, and C. What you can do? You can type same like a string letters. Press dot and press tab. The moment you press tab, all the methods which are available inside the list will appear here. Press tab. Can you see that? There are lots of elements which are available here. Can you see? Right? There are different methods which are available here, which you can use to modify your list. Okay. So right now, suppose my task is to append an element. Append an element at the end of the list. Append an element at the end of an existing list. So there is the element right now having A, B, and C. Suppose I wish to add one more element to it. I wish to add one more element to it at the end. I repeat, at the end of the list. So I will use method known as just press APP to automatically type is append. Okay. Put the bracket. And whatever element you want to push there. Whatever element you want to put there, number or string or a list itself, doesn't matter. Anything you can put itself, anything. For example, I want to place D there. So I type D as a string. Okay. Let me run this. And you will see now, if you see your list now, letters, check it. What is happening? At the end, D has been appended. Is it fine, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if you want to put your element at the end of the list, you have to use the method known as append method. Okay. Similarly, this is not a single element. You can append as many elements you want. For example, I'm again going letters dot append. I go inside. Let me check what arguments it can take or its definition. I'm going inside the bracket, pressing shift and tab. Okay. You can put any object. It's mentioned any object you can put here and append object to the end of the list. Okay. Earlier, what was happening? I just put D here. Suppose I'm putting a list here. Even I can put a list here like 1, 2, 3. Okay. I'm taking a list 1, 2, 3. So what it will do? It will take consider it as an object. An entire list as such with these brackets will be appended at the last. Can you check that? Please let me go there and run it and check it. Please check. At the end, a list as it is has been attached there. Is it fine? Please tell me. Everyone, please.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, suppose instead of attaching or appending it like this way, the putting the list symbol, then 1, 2, 3. I want to insert these elements 1, 2, 3 at the end of my list ABCD. But I have this list available with me, 1, 2, and 3 only. Okay. So how can I do that? I don't have individual element. If I would have individual element, I could have done easily by append 1, append 2, append 3. Then 3 step I would have used. Suppose I have a list only 1, 2, 3. But what I want, instead of appending like this as a list of 1, 2, 3, I want to append individual elements. So what I can do now, two methods are there. I'll tell you both of them. Letters. My list name is letters dot extend. Extend. Now inside this, place your list. Okay, place your list object. I place it there. Let me run this, run successfully, and let me check the letters. Can you check now? Now 1, 2, and 3 have been placed as an individual element. So you can understand what to use and when. And this comes with the practice only. What is your requirement? Accordingly, you will act up. Is it okay, everyone? Please tell me. Please.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, now, sir. Suppose there is one more way. Suppose I'm using letters, my list, which is having these elements, A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, A, B, C. What I'm doing, I'm using a concatenation sign and putting one more list, like 7, 8, 9. Let's run this. What just happened? Can you see? I get 7, 8, 9 automatically appended at the last. Okay. But do one thing. It will check it. Let me check my letters original. What happened? That didn't change in original. That is the main thing. Okay, if I'm using this method, means if I'm using the method of the list itself, I'm using the method of the list help, then the change is happening in place, means in the same list I'm working on. But while I'm using this operation like this, then what is happening? It is appending. But if you want to use it, you have two ways. Either assign it to the letters itself, then perfectly fine. This new letters will have all these values. Okay, so now your original list will become like this, or you can assign to any other variable like X. Is it okay, everyone? How to use it? Right? For example, you want to do something for the time being only. Let me try. Let me take my original list to be as it is. Something else is there. Let me append it, but I want to keep it separate from my original list. In that case, it is fine. In that case, this is fine. But take any variable. Make it as a list like this. I hope it is clear to everyone. Please. Fine. Please tell me.
Yes, sir. It's fine.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So I'm moving ahead. Now, what is happening with the append is that every time you are going to insert the element, they're always going to go at the last, at the end of the list. But in case I want to insert my data at a specific location, so I do have an option. Still, I do have an option. How? So this is my list letter. I can see that. What I want to do, I want to type letters. Sorry, again, it's doing some letters. Okay. See, dot insert method now. Letters dot insert method. And what it needs two arguments. One, the index where you want to place, and second, what you want to place. So if you want to check what its definition is, just go inside, press shift and tab together. It will open its definition. Okay. So it is telling you index and object. Okay. So suppose at first position only, at the first position, right now at the first position, what we are having? A. But what we want to insert now? Suppose at first position, instead of A, I want to insert anything like my name. So I press comma and I want to insert my name at expression. Okay. Let me do that. Done. And let me check the letters again. Can you see? Can you see all these items have been shifted to the right hand side? All these items have been shifted to the right hand side, and Praveer has been placed at the first position. So any location you want to insert, you can do that. Any index position you want to insert that, you can do that. None of the element has been deleted. Everything is present there. C, A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Just their index position has been changed because now the zeroth index will be known by Praveer. Is it okay, everyone? Please tell me. So remember, understand the importance, understand the requirement. Same thing we did. Same thing we did while we were trying to assign Python interpreter, different directory. We used two methods, remember? Append method and the insert method. Remember or not? Both the things we studied already while we were using sys file, system module. Remember or not, please? Same thing we did, append and insert. So same thing is here. Is it okay now? So we know how to insert data now, or how to add data to my list now. Now suppose I want to remove the data. Now task is different. Addition, now I know I can place at any position I want. I can place at the end, I can place at the starting, I can place at the beginning, anywhere I can put. If I'm sure that I want to put it at the last, go with the append method. If I'm sure I want to put at that index location only, go with insert method. Okay. And if you want to extend your list with any other iterable, then go with the extend method. If you want to see here, let me copy this so that you can understand the definition. Always read the definition of any function or any method that you are using. Okay. And how to read the definition? Go here, remove this, and press shift and tab. So see what it is saying, what it needs inside iterable. That is very important. It needs an iterable here. Okay, for example, can I put my name here? Please tell me. Can I put my name here? It needs an iterable. So can I put my name here?
Yes.
Why? It needs an iterable. Praveer is iterable. Please, I'm waiting for your answers.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It's a string, right? It's a string. String, sir. It's a string. So it is an iterable, right? So can you tell me how will it be stored inside the lattice? Now you should have strong understanding how it will be stored inside the list.
P, comma, R, comma, A.
Like yes, that. Perfectly. Perfectly, because it's an iterable. Right? So what is going to happen? At the end, I'll get P, R, A, V, R. Okay. So prior to uploading anything, understand properly what is going to happen. Okay. That is very important. Let me run that. And can you see that? At the end, how I'm getting? P, R, A, V, E, E, R. Okay. So understanding of iterable, what is iterable, what can be put it over there is very important. And don't take it, if somebody knows this, he's very intelligent, nothing like that. If somebody practice, he will become intelligent, and that obviously, that is the only thing. Just practice, practice and practice. With the practice, things become easy for us. Okay. So now moving ahead, now let's try to remove elements from our element. Okay. Let's try to remove elements from our list. So how to do that? So I'm again calling my list, lattice. I'm using first method, that is pop method. Okay. Pop method. If I want to search its definition inside, I know what it does. If I don't put an argument here, it's an optional argument inside. If I don't put an argument here, it will remove the last element of the list. It will remove the last element of the list. Okay. So you want to check? Let me do one thing. Shift enter. So see what it's saying, index equal to minus one. And you know what is minus one? Minus one is the last element. Right? Very
last
good.
Element.
And especially read what it is saying. Remove and return. That is very important. Remove and return item at index means it will also return a value which you can save anywhere you want. Okay. Suppose that what I want to do, I want to pop elements at the same time, whatever elements it is popping out, I want to store them somewhere. So what I can do, see properly. I created an empty list here. Suppose elements popped, name is elements underscore popped. Okay. So I'm sure it will remove the last element. It will return as well. It will return that element as well. So what I can do, elements popped equals to empty list. Okay. And what I can do here, elements dot append. And inside this, I can put this letters dot pop. Understand please what I'm doing. I'm sure that letters dot pop will remove the last element of the letters list. And it will return that. So output of it will be what? It will be an element. It will be an element known as last element. That will be R. So what I am doing? So in fact, letters.pop will give me R. If you want to check it, let's go here and you can check it here. If I run this only this one, letters.pop. If I run this only, letters.pop. Okay, let me run this. Can you see what it returned to us? It returned to us R. Right? So if I wanted to store this R, I can do that. How? I created an empty list here. And in this empty list, I know how to put the elements. And one of the simplest methods is to use the append method. So what I did, elements.append, letter.pop. Now, whatever it will return, that will be stored inside. So can anybody tell me now, if I will run this, what elements underscore pop will have? If I run this one time only. Please tell me.
Reverse of your word.
No. I'm running only once. I'm running only once. Then what R elements underscore? R has been already popped out. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
Right? Can you check here? Let us check letters. Okay. And let me check it. Letters. See? R has gone. Right?
E will be there.
Yes. E will be there. Okay. And this can be a smarter method. If somebody says reverse your list, right? Getting my point? If somebody says that reverse your list, don't use any built-in method, just reverse your list. So that can be done or not. How can we done that? We know we can iterate over every element of my list. I can iterate over every element of my list. That means I can put that in my for loop. Right? And for that, I keep doing pop, append, and all the things will be done. Read or not? Please tell me. If I need to reverse my list, right? Let me do one.
Sir?
Yeah, please tell me.
Sir, actually here you have written elements underscore pop equal to empty.
It's same thing I have to put here. Yeah, please. Yeah,
okay, sir. So that's why, sir, actually.
No. Is it you are asking?
Yes, sir.
That was my typing mistake. That was typo. No problem. Okay, so let me run this and let me check it. Okay, it's been done. And let me check elements underscore pop. Okay, can you see? It's having E. So now let's do one thing. Let's create a list of list name is, let's say, S. List keyword I used, and inside that I put my name Praveer. Okay, so if I want to see what S is having, I will be having a list S having individual character of my name. Okay, fine. Now, what I want to do, I want a list, create a list. I again wanted to create a list, but now it should be like R, E, starting with R, E, E, V, A, R, P. Can we do that without using any built-in function? Please tell me. You have to think out of the box. Remember, you have to think out of the box all the time. Keep pushing yourself. Never search for solution on the internet till you are tired. Because the solutions on the internet makes you lazy. In short term, these are very good, but in the long term, it is going to give you big pain. So always trust your instinct. Work as hard as possible in programming and you'll get a solution for sure. It may be possible. Sometimes you may get failed. You are not able to write even a single piece of code. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter at all. Just push yourself, push yourself, push yourself. You'll become legion for sure. So anybody, can we make a list of reverse elements?
Using for loop, sir.
Yes. Please tell me, what should I do?
Please. Using for loop and pop function.
Okay, good. That we can do. Can you tell me the 100% accurate? Other than you, anybody can tell me what should I do? That's fine, perfectly fine. With the help of pop function and the for loop, we can do that. How to do that? Very simple, very, very simple. Suppose I created an empty list. Let's say empty, that's it. The name is empty. That name is empty. I put for character, whatever name I want to put, it's up to me. Doesn't matter here because I'm not going to use that. I'm going to use that just for how many times I want to run the loop for characters in S. Okay. What I type, empty dot append. Right. And what I want to append, remember? What I want to append? S dot pop. Right or wrong? Please tell me. Is it fine?
Yes, sir. Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So let me run this. Let me run this. Done. And let me check now my list. Am I successful or not? What happened? Missed something. How come? REEE. How come it happened? Empty.s. Are we doing some mistake or somewhere? Why it is not taking the rest of the loops? What's the problem? Four iterations it is taking only. REEV. Why not after that? V it has taken. It is not taken APV. Let me check. Let me check what is my S after. Let me check what is my S after that. Okay. Why it came out of the loop?
We popped the last element.
Pardon?
We popped, remove the last element.
No, it doesn't matter. But it's still it is still remaining there, no? S is still not empty. Okay, let me do it different way. Don't worry. Let me do it different way. For I'm putting a range function here. This is the way we should learn len. Length of S. Okay, I'm doing it. Range function length of S. And let me run this again so that S again can have the same values. Okay. S is having again the same values. Now let me try to run this. It's not working that way. Let me check empty. Yeah, that. Right? This way I'm able to get. I don't know why it was showing problem, but it should have happened. But there should be always different arsenals in your repository. Always. If one way is not working, try another way. Okay. And this is very simple thing to do. What I did, instead of depending upon that, what I made it sure that it runs for 100% for number of items which are available inside my list. Okay, so how many items are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So what I did, first of all, I am sure that I want to run my loop for 7 times. I don't know why it was coming out. So I sorted out very easily how I did it. I know I have to run my loop for 7 times. It was not running for the 7 times. So I immediately decided I have to run it for the 7 time. So how to know it have to run for the 7 time? There is a function known as len. Everyone knows in a string as well, right? There is a function known as len, which tell you how many times or how many characters that is having. So it is telling me how many characters my list is having. So immediately told me 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 characters it is having. So inside this range, actually it will become like this. range of 7. Okay, it become like range of 7. Now I'm sure it's range of 7. So how much numbers here it is going to generate? It is going to number generate from 0 to 6. That means 7 times it is going to run. So in front, first time, it will pop up first element, put there. Second time, second element, third, fourth element, fifth element, sixth element. But if I put here, actually I put 7, then it becomes hard-coded, right? Then it becomes hard-coded. Because your S can be any string. It may be possible that I'm taking input from the user, right? So, but if I put like this, instead of that, if I put len function inside this, I'm damn sure what is going to happen. Damn sure. I'm not dependent on the fixed length of the S. You change S there, doesn't matter. For example, here I put my name as well. Complete Praveer Saxena. Doesn't matter. I don't have to make change any change here because I've used the function len S. Same way it is going to work. Let me check it again. This is the beauty of the range function. Smartly, you have to use the functions. This is known as function branching. Means you should understand where I can use what function. And that simply, again, I'm saying, comes with the practice only. Is it okay, everyone? Immediately, we saw a problem and we troubleshoot that. We immediately troubleshoot that in front of you. And this is the way you will learn. If this is not possible, let me try another method. If this isn't happening, try me another method. Everything should be in your arsenal. I think this is crystal clear with everyone. Please tell me. Is it fine? Instead of hard coding it, I just make it dependent on the length of the string or length of my list. Automatically, it is working for me. Any number of items, put it there, doesn't matter. It will deal with that. Fine? So you can make a function out of this or not. You can make easily function out of this. Okay, any function you give the input, it will reverse that. You give the input, it will reverse that immediately. Okay, so now move ahead. So we know what pop will do. Pop will remove the last element. But if you want to remove not the last element, any other element. So let me check once again. What is my S now? S should be empty. Nothing is there. Okay, fine. So let me create one more list. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I create one more list now for my operations. And what I'm trying to do, I want to remove, suppose, a first element. So what is the index of the first element? What is the index of the first element?
Zero.
Okay. Suppose I want to remove this 3 element. What is the index of that?
2.
Right? So nothing I have to do. I have to just put s.pop again and put the index there. That's 2. Okay, so I'm running it. Can you see? It removed 3 from there and returned 3. Removed 3 from there and returned 3. If I check S, it won't have 3 now. It won't have 3 now because I've removed the 3. See, 3 has gone. Is it fine, everyone? Okay. Yes. Now, suppose the condition is that we don't know the index. You don't know the index at which location it is having. Because it may be possible a list may be having 1,000 or millions of data. Then how will you recognize where is my index of this element? Okay. So what is a better way of doing it? Although we have covered this earlier when I was using again system module. How can I do that? Suppose I want to remove element number 4. I know I want to remove element number 4. So what I have to put? I have to put S dot remove. And put it whatever element you want to remove. What do you want to remove? You want to remove 4. Okay. Now instead of index, I'm putting the value. Because value can be anywhere. Okay. For example, you have a student list in your college and somebody leaves the college. So what you will do? Either you should know his index to remove the item using pop method, or you just know his name. His name is this. Please remove it from the list. It happens now. So if somebody leaves the college, we immediately remove his name from the list. So if I need to remove his name from the list, so I need to know the value. So I'm putting 4 here and I'm running it. Okay, check S. 4 has gone now. Understand the use cases where you will be using which methods. Is it fine? Okay, so what it will do, it will remove the first occurrence of this. Wherever first time 4 is coming, it will remove that. In case 4 is coming multiple times, it won't remove that. But if you want to remove that, you can do that and take it as an assignment in yourself. How can I remove multiple items? But you can do that. Trust me, you can use loops and you can remove multiple times 4 as well. Multiple times. Can you think of it or not? Please tell me. Can you remove 4 if it is having multiple times in your list? Can you remove it? You know one method only, ask.remove, which removes the first occurrence. Can you remove further? Very, very easy. Please tell me. Very easy. How to do that? Simple. Loop over your list. First time apply, remove. Okay. If 4 is there, it will remove in the first step. But remaining sir, 4. Yeah, please tell me.
I have a doubt. So if you want to remove the 4, so the Python would, what would Python interpret it as? Would it interpret that as for string character or as
No. The make it available in your that one. If you have made your 4 as a string, for example, let me make this one. Okay. It won't remove that. See, I'm making it as a string. I'm making it as a string, right? And while I'm removing it, I'm giving as an integer. I'm not giving as a string. I'm giving as an integer. Now see what will happen. I've just run this once more. Let me run this. Run. See, this element is not available in the list. Why? Because you are supplying numeric data and it is available as a string. So in case I want to remove string, so I have to supply my this number as a string only, like this. I hope your doubt is clear now.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if I check it now, it's gone. Fine. So please understand okay. that. Okay, whatever data type you have supplied inside the list, same way you have to put it there. Same way. Right. So moving ahead, there is one way to remove. There are other ways as well. There is a statement in the Python known as del. See, can you see that? The moment I type it, turned green. That is a keyword. Okay. Suppose I want to remove the first element of the or any element of the list. Any element. Very easily, I can do that. I have to use the list, and in the square bracket, use its index. Suppose I want to remove first element only. That is 0th index. Just do that. It will remove that. You can check it. Okay. First gone. And the benefit of this is that as well means instead of removing one element, this del can remove multiple elements as well. You can remove multiple elements of Excel. For example, I want to remove element. Let's see. Let me create a list. This again, S. Let me run this again because S has gone. So now I'm trying to do del. S colon 0, 2. Okay. Before that, let me run S so that you can understand what is getting removed. S is having 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm having del as 0, 2. Let me run S. Let's see what S is having now. See. Can you guess what has happened? You know, Python is 0 index, and whatever element we put at the end, it will take always 1 less than that. So which elements it is going to delete? 0 and 1. So 0th index, we are having 1. 1th index, we are having 2. So we are able to remove it. Is it fine, everyone? So how many methods till we know to remove the elements from the list? One method is to use pop, right? One method is to use remove. One method is to use del. There is one more thing. One more. But instead of removing individual elements, what it will do? See, my list name is S and it is having 2 elements, 3 and 4. I use a method known as clear method. What it will do? Let me run it. You will see that. It will remove all elements from the list. Doesn't matter how many elements it is having. It will remove all the elements from the list. So your list will become an empty list now. See, I clear. And let me check S. Can you see that? Okay. So how many methods? Now we know to remove the elements from the list. Pop, remove, del, and clear. be cautious from clear. Be cautious from clear, because clear is going to remove all elements from your list. Is it fine, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now moving ahead. Let's move ahead. Next thing is, suppose again I have a list, name is lettuce, and that list is having element A, element B, element C. Okay. And I want to find out what is the index of A, or what is the index of B, or what is the index of C. There is a method in this. How? Print. Example, I want to print that method, that is lettuce dot index. Okay, index, and put whatever value you want. For example, I want to search the index of A or index of B. So what is the index of B? We know the value of index B is 1. Let me run that. Sorry. How come it is doing that? Letter of index A, B, C. Did I made some mistake? Yeah, I was doing mistake. Here I have typed triple T and bottom I have typed triple 2. Let me run this again. See, please. Yeah, fine. So letters is having B at first index 0 and 1. So it is running me 1. In case you are searching for an element, I'm copying it again. Searching for an element which is not available here, let's say D. You're searching for an element which is not available in the list. Let me run that. What it will do, it will show in value error. Let's see. Can you see that? It said that D is not in list. D is not in list, okay? But this is the not desired method actually. What happens, suppose you're running a program in which you are checking something. Okay, you are checking something, and unfortunately, suppose you forget to type your D character. Unfortunately, you forget to type your D character, and you run a program and you move somewhere. So what will happen? Your program will stop immediately. It will not execute further. It will not execute further, right? So if you want to prevent this value error, means if it, even if it is not available, I don't want value error to come because my program will halt there. So there is a method. How can we overcome this value error method? How can we overcome this value error method? So what I will type, see properly, please. If what I want to search, D, which is not available in there, but you can use it for any, every character, for every character you want to do, right? For if D in letters, if D in letters, okay? If D in letters means, if this condition is true, means D is available inside the letters. If D is available inside the letters, then this condition will be true. If it is the case, then give me the index of D. Then give me the index of D. Okay. So I said letters dot index. This way your program won't crash, or it won't show your value error. It won't show your value error, right? So I'm doing that. Let's take a practical example of that. Suppose you are having password stored somewhere and you want to match every character with the index. At this position, this should be there. This is how your program is stored. Remember, you have a particular location. Suppose you are setting a password as example 123789. So at first position, 1 should come. At second position, 2 should come. Third position, 3 should come. So they have fixed index position. And you want to compare the password with the same, means one is coming at the one position or not, two is coming at the second position or not. So do you want it? Means while your system is checking the password, you want your system to crash, or you want to just move through? Or you want to move through, right? You don't want your system to crash. In that case, what you can do? You can use this kind of methods. If D in letters, print it. Otherwise, do anything, whatever you want. Is it fine? But we can do one thing. If D in letters, we can do here else. If this is not executed, mention that character, it won't crash. Character not available in database or list. Yeah, let me run this. Is it fine? Smarter way. Instead of showing value error, your program stopped. Is it a finer way or not? Please tell me.
Yes.
Okay. This is the way actually programmers work. They always, you know, every team has a testing team as well. Whenever you are going for a software programmer, they have a testing team. So before bringing any of your product to the market, there is a testing team which generates test benches. Okay. And those test benches run on your program. And those test benches normally include every sort of combination which is available to check the performance of your program. Right? To check the performance of your program. And if it is error, they will immediately tell you there is an error. The testing team does that. I hope it is okay. And if having any single doubt, please tell me. Even a single doubt if anyone is having. Please, I'm waiting.
No, sir.
Okay. Because now we have studied Python that much, at least that much, that you can start thinking. And I'm proud that several of you have submitted assignment. They have been the beautiful assignment, except few small mistakes. That is acceptable if you are learning Python for the first time. Those are acceptable. For example, a few people, what I have done. So for example, we have to use multiple if statement, that is elif statement. So in the last statement as well, when every condition is checked and last condition is remaining, for example, somebody is having number 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 50 to 60, 70 to 80. They are still using elif in the last condition as well. That is not required, right? Why? Else will do that. You'll understand that way. I'll give you individual feedback. Don't worry about that. But I've seen few codes. Okay, so you can understand things. When all the conditions are tested, last is remaining, you can put else. Why to put elif again, right? So there are some problems that no worry about that. Okay, so I'm moving ahead. So suppose I have a list. I'm taking a list now known as numbers, and now task will be different. Okay. Numbers, and numbers are having the values 3, 5, 2, 8, 6. This is my list. Okay. Please mute yourself. Somebody is unmuted. Thank you. Okay. So there is a list, numbers, and I want to sort them. I want to sort them. Don't worry. This is the beauty of list. Everything is available there. You don't have to work very much hard there. What I have to do, simply I have to call number dot a method known as sort method and see what it does. Let me put bracket here and go shift and tab. It will have two arguments. You will see one argument will be key and other will be your different argument, which you can see there. Let me run shift and tab. Shift. Why it's not working? Sorry, numbers is there. Numbers dot sort. Let me press shift and tab. See? So two arguments are there. One, your key. I'll tell you very soon about the key. Don't worry about that. And second one is reverse is equals to false. Reverse equal to false means you want to sort your list in reverse order or ascending order or descending order, as simple as that. As simple as that. Take it that way. Okay. So by default, what they have done, say key they have sent to none means if you're not using, don't use it. I'll tell you what when the key will come into the picture. And second thing is reverse equal to first. No, I don't want to reverse that string. I just want ascending order. So if you don't put it, it will be do ascending order. Let me run this. Let me run this, and you will see that if I check my numbers, it will be in the ascending order numbers. Can you see? It was not in ascending order, 3, 5, 2, 8, 6. It has smartly arranged everything in the ascending order. Suppose I don't want ascending order. I want descending order. Okay. I want descending order. Let me take this list only. It doesn't matter. It's an ascending order. I have to convert into the descending order, or I can convert descending order this as well. So what I can do, small change I have to make. Numbers dot sort. Remember, there was an argument known as reverse, which was set as false by default. Okay, I have to just make it true here. That's it. False by default is there. You can check it out. If you doubt me, just go there, shift tab and see. Reverse equal to false. Let me copy it. Don't worry. That's easier way. Copy it. Instead of false, just make it true. Okay. Just make it true. Run this. Come back. Check numbers. It will be in the reverse orders. Please check it. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Everyone, please.
Yes, sir.
Is it okay? Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let's move ahead. There is sort method. There is one more function, right? There is one more function which is known as sorted, which will do the same task. But what is happening here is, whenever we are applying this function, number dot sort, it is happening in place, means same list is getting modified. You have seen that. 35286, after sorting, it has changed here. Again, reverse true, it has changed here. There's one more list which won't perform the task in place, means your original list will remain same. Okay, so what we can do is this, simple. I'm calling a method known as sorted method now. Let me use this number, sort it. And now see this number, this list is in the reverse order, doesn't matter. Inside this sorted method, I'm putting my numbers. Okay. And suppose I'm storing it somewhere, let's say X. Okay. X equal to sorted numbers. Why I'm doing that? Because what is happening? It is going to sort the number, but original numbers will remain same. I'll show you that, don't worry. Because what I should do, I should print here X. Okay, so that I can see the result of sorted, and I should print here numbers as well. What is my original numbers? Remember that my numbers is 86532, and X should be in ascending order. Can you check? Numbers, we are printing numbers later. Numbers are as it is, the way they were. This one, 86532. But the sorted function has sorted my numbers, but it has not changed the original list. So if I need that change number, I have to store it somewhere else. So I use a variable where I store that sorted list. Okay, so this is the sorted list which is available. Okay, so in case you want your original list to be remain as it is, you want a sorted list, you don't want the change to be reflect in the original list. So be sure with that. Is it fine?
Please again explain.
Okay, I'm explaining again. In these method that I'm calling numbers.sort, right? What is happening? Whatever method we are applying, it is happening in place, means same list is going to be modified. Okay, because earlier our number was 35286. When I apply sort method, it's sorted and saved same thing inside the numbers. So my new numbers become 23568. It no longer remain the original list, right? It no longer remain the original list, it remain the modified list. But there is a method known as sorted method, which perform the same task of sorting. Same task of sorting. It takes an argument as a list. Okay. It sorts the number. It sorts your list, but do not make any changes inside your original list. So original list remains same the way you have provided. Okay. If you want the sorted result to be saved somewhere else, use a variable here. So in this variable, I have used the result of sorted numbers. That's why the original numbers were 86532. After sorting, it will become 23568. And it has been stored in X. But my original numbers remain same as 86532, which is here. Is it clear? If you don't, tell me, I will explain again. No issue with that.
Yes, sir. It will show the first sorted number, after that the original numbers.
No, don't. This program will do that. But what is the difference between these two numbers? Understand this. If I use this numbers dot sort, okay, this is one way of sorting. If my list is numbers, if I use this one, sorted numbers, there is a big difference between these two. What it will do, it will sort the number for sure, but store the sorted number in the original list only. Is it fine? or in the list known as numbers.
Yes, yes.
It won't make the changes in the, it will sort, but it won't make changes in the original number. So if you want the result of sorted one, store it somewhere. I hope it is clear now.
Yes, sir.
Okay, perfect. Now a bit challenging task is coming. So let me write as a comment so that you can understand. And even you can do one more thing here. You can do one more thing here. Numbers by default will sort the number in the ascending order. If you want to sort it in the reverse descending order, it can do that for sure. For example, same way you can write reverse equal to. It will accept that. The sorted function will also accept. Okay, it can have your list. It can have this function as well. By default, it is set to false. But if you make it true, so let me generate a list here so that you can understand the number. And I'm generating new list known as num1 example. And list is having numbers 34, then 2, then 23, then 43, then let's say 19, then 17, something like that. Okay. I want to sort it in the descending order. So I put reverse equal to true. So instead of numbers, I'm supplying his num1. Okay. So num1 will be sorted, but original num1 will not change. So if I want to check the original num1, I'm putting it num1. Okay. So my x will be descending this one, but num1 will be originally this one. Okay. So let me check this. Is it okay?
Now I got it, sir.
Okay, fine. Great. So next task is, suppose I have a list of items. And this list of item is having tuples inside this, like product one, okay, is a string, comma. Let's say price is, let me take any price, 10. Then again, a tuple known as product. And its price is, let's say, 9 rupees. Okay. Again, one more tuple. It is product 3. And let's say its price is 12 rupees. Okay. This is a list. If I try to sort this list, my Python interpreter doesn't know how to sort it. So let me run this. Items dot sort. Let me check, is that been sorted or not, items. Oops, nothing happened. Nothing at all could happen because how the Python will know how I have to sort it? It doesn't understand how to sort it. In such cases, you have to devise your everything in a proper manner. How? Understand. Suppose I want to sort this list in terms of price. I want to sort this list in terms of price, right? Means first entry should be product 9 here, product 2 and 9, then product 1 and 10, and last product 3 and 10. Understand my requirement is, I want to sort this list according to this entry, which is available here. Okay. And as we can see that these are tuples. If somehow, we can access these. Okay. If somehow we can access these, then we can sort them for sure. So we have to think this way because remember, I skipped one thing here. If you remember, if you go inside and press shift tab, I haven't explained you this key thing. Now this key thing will come into the picture. This key is nothing but a function actually. Now see, what I am going to do, did you understand what my task is? What is my task? To sort this item list in terms of these numbers which are mentioned here. Okay, suppose these are the product and these are the prices. So I want to sort this in terms of products. Is it fine? Please tell me. Yes. Task is clear. Whatever task is.
Yes, sir. We want to sort the product prices.
Yes, product prices means we won't like this earlier. Here is just coming product 1 and 10, here product 2 and 9, here product 3 and 10. But which is having the smallest price? product 2. So first entry should be product 2 and 9. Second entry should be the highest, higher price than the 9. Then which it is? This one. So it will come here. And third price should be this one. Somebody has messaged me. Sir, at least who is asking Rakesh? Rakesh, once this portion is completed, then only machine learning will be completed, right? We have to complete this concept first of all. We have to complete Python, which is basic required. Mr. Rakesh Ahuja is actually asking me, can you please inform us when the machine learning concept will be discussed? Actually, prior to machine learning, there are several things needs to be covered. One, Python, as we have given the schedule as well. If you have seen that, first Python basics are required, then your NumPy and then Pandas. That okay, and after that data analysis. Actually machine learning is just about writing an algorithm. That is very easy task, right? But before that, how it works, what is the thing behind, how you judge what machine learning algorithms are going to work on the basis of that, it will be working. I hope you understand, right? Okay, so I want to start it. Is it clear, everyone? Right, so now what I am going to do, let me see, I'm creating a function, and then function name is sort underscore item. Okay. And what it takes as an argument, the name is item. Let's say item. Okay. It will take the item, means every item of your list. First argument, second argument, and third argument. And we can see all of these individual arguments are a tuple. Okay. And in this, that what we are bothered of, we are bothered about this number. We are not bothered about first, what is first? We are bothered about this, right? We are bothered about this. So what we want from every tuple, I want this number. From every this, we want to get this number, fine? So what we can do, we put colon here. And you know how to get a tuple element? Return. What do you want? Whatever item you will get first item, example, product 1 and 10, right? From product 1 and 10, what do you want? You want product 1? If you want product 1, you will mention item, then indexing is done with the help of square brackets, then you will put 0. If you need first element, but we don't need this. What do we need? We need second element, and second element index will be, please can you tell me? What will be the second index element inside this tuple?
1.
Yes, so I'll put 1 here. Okay, now see what is going to happen. A magic is going to happen. Let me run this, done successfully. Now see, now use your list. What is your list name? List name is items.sort. Got that? Items.sort. Items.sort. Again, same method is there. Now your key will come into the picture. So how will you mention? How will you mention? You will mention with the keyword argument, key equals to. Okay, what is the key? Means how you are going to access that? Your key is going to be your function name. What is your function name? Sort underscore item. Okay, just put that here. No need to put arguments. Sort underscore item. What is going to happen? Understand now. Your item is an iterable, right? It's having different elements. First element, second element, third element. Okay. So how it is going to work? It will take your individual element of this items, take this element. On this element, apply this function. That is sort item. Okay. So it will apply sort item. Once it applies sort item, what it will do, it will return item 1. So what will be the value coming here? The value coming here will be first 10. Right? First value will be coming as 10. Then item is an iterable. So again, I'll move to the second element. A same function will be applied to the second element. That is this. Right? Once it is applied, again, what will be written? Item 1. So its first index element will be 9. So 9 will be written. Again, we'll move to the next element, that is product 3 for 12. Okay. We'll apply this function, sort underscore item, the same. Now what it will return? It will return its second value, that is this. So now we have 10, 9, 12. Now it will sort. Now it is going to sort it. And once it is sorted, you know, this is first, this is second, and this is last. Automatically, the things will work for you. See, let me run this and let me print your item. Print your items list. And check this. This is very important. At the same, little bit more demanding from your side. Little bit more demanding. See properly. It was not able to do properly because what was happening? We were having a tuple. How to deal with that? Very simple. First of all, design a key, a function, which will give you the element on basis of which you want to sort. On the basis of which you want to sort. Now put that function inside your sort method. That's it. As simple as that. First, design a method which gives you this element. Is it fine, everyone? Please tell me. Let me make it more challenging now. Let me create one more list. You'll understand easier now. Okay. Now I'm using items, and let me say product one, and I'm putting here one more thing. Let's say grocery. Okay, grocery. Okay, and its price is, let's say 31 rupees. Okay. Product two is, say, let's say dairy item. Okay. And its price is, let's say 20 rupees. Okay. Product three is, let's say, what should I say? Food item, or say fast food of anything, whatever you want, fast food. Okay. And its price is, let's say, anything you want to put 35, let's say 35, or you want to put 25, okay, 25. Now you people will tell me, I want to sort this list on the basis of these prices. Can you do that now or not? Please tell me. I want to sort this list on the basis of these elements.
Yeah.
Can you do that?
Sir, daily ke aage comma lagega, fast food ke aage comma.
Yeah, comma. Yes, I forgot to put a comma here. Please now tell me, can you sort it?
Sir, item ka index jo change kar denge 2 pe to ho sakta
hai. Yes, simple thing. See, this is again a tuple. But what element you want? You want this element. Which element? 31, right? So I'm using here, and let me give a different name, items one. Okay, items one. And I want element to be index 2, 0, 1, and 2, 0, 1, and 2, 0, 1, and 2. That's it. As simple as that. Okay. So I'm running this, calling my items1list.sort, and putting my key here. And what is key? Keys again, sort_item. That's it. Do that. Some mistake is there. Where the mistake is, check it, please. Either in typing somewhere, there should be some mistake. Name items one is not defined. Items, I write perfectly, I defined it. Why it is swing like this?
Sir, in sort item.
Pardon? No. I declared here items one, right?
Sir, in function.
In function, sort item.
No, that is different. No, doesn't matter. That doesn't matter at all. All items, let me run it again. Okay.
Sir, you are missing S in return.
Pardon?
You are missing S in...
No, wait.
Item.
I don't think so. I'm doing any mistake. Items 1 dot sort. Perfect, fine. Yeah, no mistake was there. I don't know why it was showing mistake. Okay. Now you can check. Items 1. Want to see product 2 dairy 20, product 3 fast food 25, product 1 grocery 31. Is it fine, everyone? I hope you people will be able to do that now. Understand what is key here? Please tell me.
Yes sir.
Everyone.
Yes sir.
Yes sir.
Okay, now this is one way of writing this function. Now let's move that will be the last thing for the day. I'm moving to a very important concept, although it is very easy, known as lambda functions. Lambda functions or anonymous functions. Anonymous functions. The functions without name. Simple as that. Anonymous means the functions without name. That's it. Functions without any name is known as anonymous functions. Okay. And these functions can be defined without using def keyword. Normally, how do we define function? Remember, we use the keyword def. Use the keyword def, but you can define your lambda functions or anonymous function without using your def. Okay. So what is the syntax of lambda functions? Very simple. Very, very simple thing. How can we define lambda functions? A simplest thing you can do it. Suppose I have a variable. First of all, if using a variable, you have to write the keyword lambda. L-A-M-B-D-A. Okay. Lambda. Now, the variables you want. How many variables you want? Suppose you want operation on only one variable. Then put that variable. Suppose X. Any name you can put. Doesn't matter. X, A, B, C. Anything you want to put, put there. After colon, what do you want to return from this function? Right? Like this. For example, here, what I was doing, I want to use on one item, that is item. And what I want to return, item two. So whatever you want to do on this X, for example, I want to square the X. Whatever value of X will be there, I want to square of that. So I will define X, X to the power two. Your function is declared. No name needs to be given. And anywhere you want to use it, use it. Anywhere you want to use it, use it. For example, what I did, even if I want to assign a name to it, for example, I'm doing this lambda function. Suppose I want to assign, it can be directly used. It can be directly used in any other your function or any other method you are using. For example, I will use it here as well. I will use it here just in a few of seconds, right? So suppose I'm putting this as a comment and I wish to give it a name. How? I copied this lambda and the name is square. I give it a function, a name is square. My wish. You can give that. And the function is what? Lambda x, x to the power square. Again, lambda x, x to the power square. Right? Let me run this. And once we run this, now you can use this function. How? Square. Function name is square. So how many arguments lambda needs? Can you say it needs only one argument, x. So within the bracket, put your x. For example, I put two. Whatever you want to put, put it there and run this. You will get your four. As simple as that. Even you don't need that. If sometimes you need to define a function, later on to use it, use it. You don't have to define it by the def method. Just use variable name, whatever variable is there. Even two variables you want to use. For example, if I want to create a function like this, addition of two variables. So I can put L-A-M-B-D-A lambda, two variables A comma B. And what I want to do, I want to do addition of, I want to return A plus B. So I will do A plus B. I hope you get an idea. Okay. And suppose I same way, I want to name this function as add function. Add equals to lambda AB A plus B. Right. So I find to use that. Now, while you are using this function, you know, lambda has two variables. So take two variables, add 3, 4, and will return you 7. I hope you get an idea of lambda functions. Please tell me. Is it fine? Very, very easy way, yes. Right? Very easy. Nothing to be done. Now see, what I'm going to do. Earlier, I was defining this function, def sort or something. I won't do that now. I won't do that anymore. Okay. So let me copy this list again. Which one? Any list we can copy. Suppose the same list I'm copying here, which I created, where I created items one. Let me copy this list. Okay. Let me run this so that it is unordered, means not sorted. Let me check the value of items. One, yeah, not order 31, 20, 25. Okay, now same thing I want to apply, but this time I won't declare def function. I won't declare def function. I will use lambda function. What I will do, items one dot sort, items one dot sort. Then what I wrote key equals to, here I wrote my function name, right? Here I wrote my function name. Now I won't write my function name. I won't write, I will use lambda. Okay, lambda. And how many arguments your def function were having? Can you check it there? How many items it were having? Only one argument it was asking for, item. And what it want to return? Item bracket two. This thing only, argument this and return this. I argument this, return the same thing do here. Item, colon, item. Is it fine, everyone? Please tell me.
Yes.
Right, nothing special. Just use your variable that you want to use it. Even the item name doesn't matter. Item, you want to give any other name, it's up to you. It's entirely up to you, whatever name you want to give it. Run it. Check item once now. Go. Items one. And check, it is sorted. Okay, so directly I'm using inside another method. And how small it is. I don't have to declare function explicitly. It is going to work. These are the power of your lambda functions or anonymous functions. Is it okay, everyone?
Yes, sir.
Please tell me.
Yes, sir.
Others, please. I want to ask you one thing, but please, you can be honest me. Are you finding it boring or something? Be honest, please.
No, sir.
You can be honest. Oh, you can be honest here. I don't mind. Seriously, I'm a kind of person who wants to improve all the time. If somebody wants to, actually, that he messaged me, na, that's why I'm but hesitant. Rakesh sir actually asked me, that's why I'm he wants to learn machine learning. That's the main thing. Machine learning will come. But actually, thing is that I can go to the machine learning directly. But trust me, you will find a lot of difficulty. A lot of difficulty. The aim should be not a short-term goal, right? The thing should be, the system should be groomed in a proper way, right or wrong? Everything should be done in a systematic manner. Was this thing means, what are the primary requirements to learn the machine learning, right? That is the main thing. Even if you see that, I've please somebody's unmuted. Okay. Actually, trust me, there are lots of people who are learning machine learning courses. And please, honestly, ask them the feedback. You'll understand everything. They cover machine learning in 5 days or 6 days. It's impossible. Almost impossible. Okay. I even attend a machine learning training and I paid nearly 1 lakh rupees. Okay. And trust me, I spend, but was nothing less than false promises. They gave, although I was never intended to get a placement from them, but they gave assurance to the people that they will provide 100% placement up to package of minimum 6 lakh to 18 lakhs. They give that kind of assurance to the people. Okay. And in lieu of that, several people joined them. Several people. They always say, you're giving a written 100% written guarantee of 100% feeding, 100% placement. And so far as I know at least 100 people out of them who have registered with them, none of them is placed. Okay. Even they send us, there are a few companies which are calling. Okay. And they send the name of those companies which are never heard of. And how much package they are offering, will you believe, you will never join. 2 lakh rupees per annum, 2.5 lakh rupees per annum, even 10,000 rupees per month. Okay. So people are making fool others in terms of lucrative offers. You will get this much placement or this much placement. I'm just giving you an advice. Whenever you want to join somewhere institute, main focus should be that you get a quality thing. You get things in details. That is a very much important thing. Ultimate thing that is going to be with you for life is your knowledge. Trust me on this. Your knowledge is never going to let you go down. But if you believe in any kind of shortcut, for now I will do a, I'm also a part of a Telegram group. Okay. I'm actually a data analyst as well. So I provide consultancy to different organizations as well, right? I'm a Microsoft certified data analyst. So I've joined a group where all the professionals are linked. And trust me, out of there are 17,000 professionals in that group. Every day I receive requests for, they used to post in the group. We need proxy for interview support. We need proxy for job support. We need proxy for anything else. Everywhere means the people are relying on shortcuts. You know proxy, what is proxy? It means you have an interview and I'm giving your interview. This is known as proxy. So people are doing this. So don't fall in any kind of trap, but the shortcuts are always going to pay you. Remember,